Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Chris Armstrong, and I'm here with Dr. Catherine Huang, who is the first author of our recently published paper in eye science. And so this publication just came out very recently. We're very excited about this publication. We've been trying to get it published for a little while now, and it's one that's working with the UK Biobank, which is a large biobank in the UK that has hundreds of thousands of people in it. And within that, we found over 1,000 ME/CFS patients and tens of thousands of controls as well. And so this study was based on that size of a cohort. And Kathy's going to give us a little rundown about kind of what happened in this paper.
Yes, thanks, Chris. I'm very excited for this paper to be out as well. So just a general idea of what we did in this MGWAS study is that we know that in ME/CFS there are a lot of different metabolic abnormalities, and our group has found a whole bunch of different potential biomarkers and other groups as well. Some of these biomarkers may be conflicting, so and contradictory in either being elevated or decreased. And so we just wanted to understand whether there was another factor contributing to why we are seeing these different pathways being enriched or downregulated in ME/CFS individuals. So what we did was we used statistical analyses to identify if any genetic variants are more enriched in a particular metabolite level. So instead of finding genetic variants specifically in ME/CFS cohort, we did it looking at metabolite levels. So these included lipoproteins, fatty acids, metabolites. And what we did is we found two genes involved in the neuroendocrine system that were more specific in the ME/CFS cohort than the healthy controls.
Yeah, great. I think that, we've had a lot of great genetic papers out this year in ME/CFS, of course, and those studies have really been focused on understanding the genes that may increase your risk or more associated with ME/CFS. And in this particular case, we're actually looked at, well, we've seen a lot of metabolic changes, especially in HDL and LDL, like as you mentioned, the lipoprotein. People will probably know at home, like cholesterol, HDL, LDL, that's what we're talking about. So we see these changes in ME/CFS versus controls. And so instead of looking at the genes that are related to specifically whether you have the illness or not, we're looking at the genes that are related to those metabolic changes that we see in this disease to see if there are key factors involved there. So I think quite a twist on what's happening, but I think nonetheless very interesting and I guess a new type of analysis. Or more recent analysis being used in research, and I think something we will follow up, right, with future work.
So obviously we still need to do future work, either wet lab or additional computational work, such as Mendelian randomization, to see how ME/CFS as an illness is connected with our genetic and metabolite associations. And then we are hoping to replicate this study design in multiple conditions, comorbidities. We also want to do some more sex stratified analyses, look at other factors that may contribute, because we all know there are a lot of different factors that contribute to your cholesterol and your lipid levels in your bloodstream. So we are also looking at integrating some external parameters such as menopause, insulin resistance, as well in future analyses.
Yeah, fantastic. I think we'll make good use of that subscription that we have to the UK Biobank, and in future studies, we'll be able to work on that in the next couple of years. Thank you so much, Kathy, for a quick chat about this, and hope everyone enjoys reading through it at home. Bye.
Thanks, Chris.